That time was the hair band era of rock and roll. So they were making fun of that kind of genre of music. And so our version was the sort of 90s, 2000 version, which is boy bands. And then another influence was Orson Welles' F for Fake.
Oh, yeah.
And that was a kind of like, again, a pseudo-documentary.
Impossible to get on video now.
Yeah, well, actually, I think there's a Criterion version of it. But the last 20 minutes is a special kind of little documentary about these missing Picasso paintings that they found. And it goes on and on about these paintings, and then at the end of it, they tell you that whole documentary was fake. And so the whole issue or the idea of blurring reality with... blurring the lines of reality was what we wanted to do with this film.
So this really was blurred for a while. That is, people, for a while before people knew a film was being made, people thought that you were in a...
Yeah, for sure. Because, well, actually, this is how it happened. We wanted to make a regular narrative film, kind of like in the way of Zoolander was, about male modeling, but instead of that, about boy bands. And when we thought about having to film a concert scene with like 3,000, audience members and having to pay for all those extras, we realized we couldn't afford to make that movie. So we dropped the project for like 6 months, and one night I was about to fall asleep, and I just sat up in bed, and I was like, wait a second, we could actually become a real boy band, and go out there and perform, and we could film our concerts, and we'd have audiences that we could film for free, and make it a low-budget version of what we wanted to do. And it actually ended up being a better idea because of the sort of mockumentary format. It really did blur the lines of reality. And so when people saw the film, well, first of all, for a year and a half, people thought we were a real boy band, and we were awful, we were horrible. There was only one guy, Terrence, in there as my best friend, who could sing, and the rest of us couldn't. So that's why he's like up front and we're in the back. But we were trying to be bad, just a gay story. And so that it was a theme that everyone could relate to. And I used that, what I could relate to put it into that character. And actually, it was funny because after I made that film, I thought, because Hong Kong is very conservative, and I thought I would be labeled as that gay actor. And in fact, it would have the opposite reaction. A lot of directors saw that movie and saw that I made, I took a risk to do a role like that and started hiring me on for other different projects. So it was actually a good thing for me.
Okay, over here. Did you have a question?
Yeah. Take that microphone. I'm so excited to be choosing. Thank you. Yesterday, I just at the wave one, say, how can I get the Daniel Stang's picture? And I'm very excited. I'm so sad to go to the health center and see you. And oh my God, I see Daniel in the school. And my question just, this is your first time to be a director?
In this movie, yeah?
Yeah. So it's different to be your movie star. It's different. So how is...
What's the difference between being an actor and a director?
Yeah.
Is that what you mean? Okay. It's very different because as an actor, you're very passive. You have control over your character and it's really a discussion between you and the director. But that's just one part of the film. As a director, you're the leader of the ship. You're the captain of the ship, and you control everything. Not just the visual aesthetic and the thematic aesthetic of the film, but also you have to lead a group of people. You have people working for you, and they need direction. They're asking questions all the time, and you have to be ready to answer that. And I think, like I said earlier, my architecture education prepared me for that. I always say architecture is very similar to directing. An architect has an idea, a concept that becomes a sketch. The sketch becomes a plan. The plan is something that you use to get people to help you build the building, craftsmen, electricians, whatever, to build the building. Directing is the same thing. You have an idea like this, a crazy idea. You sketch it out. You draw it right out of a script. You get your actors, you get your cameraman, you get your lighting people to come and help you build this thing. And also, when I'm looking at scenes in a movie, I think of them as rooms that I'm designing in a building. Each one is a different experience, emotional experience, a visual experience. It's very similar to architecture. It's all about space. It's all about framing. It's all about the experience you get while you're watching it, when you're experiencing it.
Okay, we'll have one last question, though. I think Matsue, our visiting director, has a question.
Matsue, he's over here. He's on the wall.
Okay, go ahead.